Welcome to a video on vector applications. Let's go ahead and take a look at our first problem. A ship leaves port on a bearing of 28 degrees and travels 7.5 miles. The ship then turns due east and travels 4.1 miles. How far is the ship from the port and what is its bearing? Remember, bearings are measured from due north. So if we have a bearing of 28 degrees, the ship would be traveling in this path, or this angle here would be 28 degrees, and this would have a distance of 7.5 miles. When the ship turns due east, it'll be traveling in this direction for 4.1 miles. So if we can determine the bearing and the magnitude of this resultant vector, we will be able to answer this question. Let's go ahead and take a look at our sketch in a little more detail. If this is 28 degrees, then we know this is a right angle. This angle here must be 90 degrees minus 28 degrees, or 62 degrees. Next, the x-axis and this vector here are parallel. So here we have interior angles, and these are supplementary. So if this is 62 degrees, this would have to be 180 degrees minus 62 degrees, or 118 degrees. Okay, the reason that's so important is now we can determine the length of this vector here, or its magnitude, and that'll be the distance from the port. So let's go ahead and label this vector r. So let's go ahead and label this vector r, and we'll try to find the magnitude of it using the law of cosines. The square of the magnitude of vector r is going to be equal to 7.5 squared plus 4.1 squared minus 2 times 7.5 times 4.1 times the cosine of 118 degrees. Okay, for the sake of time, I've already calculated these values. And you may want to check these for yourself, but for the sake of time, we're going to go ahead and move along. Notice here we're subtracting a negative, so we'll end up adding 28.87. So we have the square of the magnitude of r is equal to 101.93. Now we can square root both sides of the equation. So the magnitude of vector r is approximately equal to 10.1. So what that means is the ship is 10.1 miles from port. Now, to determine the bearing of this ship, we are going to have to find this angle here. So if we can find this acute angle in this triangle, we can add it to 28 degrees and then find the bearing. And we can do that using the law of sines now that we know this angle and the length of the opposite side of that triangle. We know this is 10.1 miles here. So we'll have the sine of 118 degrees divided by 10.1 must equal the sine of theta divided by 4.1. Now we cross multiply. Go ahead and divide by 10.1. We have sine theta equals approximately 0.3584. So now we'll go to our calculator and find the inverse sine of 0.5384 to determine what that angle would be. Second sine, 0.5384. And so our angle is approximately 21 degrees in this triangle. So again, this angle here is 21 degrees. So the bearing would be the sum of these two angles, or 21 degrees plus 28 degrees. That would be a bearing of 49 degrees. Let's go ahead and take a look at one more problem. Two tow trucks are pulling on a truck stuck in the mud. Tow truck one is pulling with a force of 635 pounds. At a 51 degree angle from the horizontal, while tow truck 2 is pulling with a force of 592 pounds at 39 degrees from the horizontal. What is the magnitude and direction of the resultant force? Let's go ahead and sketch these position vectors. The first direction angle is 51 degrees with a magnitude of 635. The second vector has a direction of 39 degrees with a magnitude of 592. So to find the resultant vector, we're going to have to add these together. So what we'll do is we'll use the triangular method. So I'll sketch a horizontal line parallel to the x-axis that passes through the terminal point of this first vector, And now we'll move the initial point of this blue vector up to the terminal point of the black vector. So it might look like this. So the resultant vector would have its initial point at the origin and its terminal point at the terminal point of the blue vector. So we have a triangle that has a very large obtuse angle. Let's see if we can gather some additional information from our sketch. If we know this angle here is 39 degrees, since these two blue vectors are parallel, and these horizontal lines are also parallel, if this is 39 degrees, then the angle between this dashed red line and this blue vector would also be 39 degrees. Next, if the angle between this black vector and the x-axis is 51 degrees, this angle and this angle here will be supplementary. So 180 minus 51 will give us 129 degrees for this angle. Again, 39 degrees was this small angle here. So this large obtuse angle will have a measure of 129 degrees plus 39 degrees, which is equal to 168 degrees. So this large obtuse angle here has a measure of 168 degrees. Now we can use the law of cosines to find the length of this red vector or its magnitude. So let's go ahead and label this the resultant vector. And of course, this blue vector has a length of 592, the same as the blue vector down here. Now, once we know this angle is 168 degrees, this is 592, this is 635, we can find the length of this, or its magnitude, by using the law of cosines. So the square of the magnitude of vector r is equal to 135 squared plus 592 squared minus 2 times 635 times 592 times the cosine of 168 degrees. So this angle here is really the key to setting this up and solving it. Again, for the sake of time, I've already calculated this. So the square of the magnitude of r is equal to 1,489,099.49, or approximately. So now we can take the square root of both sides. So the magnitude of r is approximately 1,220. So 1,220 pounds is a force being applied to the truck stuck in the mud. Next, they want us to determine the direction of that force. So what we'll do now is use the law of sines to determine this acute angle in this right triangle, and then from that we'll be able to figure out what this angle here would be, 51 degrees minus whatever that angle. So we'll have the sine of 168 degrees divided by 1,220 must equal the sine of theta divided by 592. Let's go ahead and take this over to the next slide. Cross multiply. Divide by 1,220. It's approximately 0.1009. So we'll go to the calculator. Inverse sine, 0.1009. This angle is approximately 5.8 degrees. Let's go back to our sketch. Again, this angle right here is approximately 5.8 degrees. Well, remember, this black vector formed a 51 degree angle with the positive x-axis. So if that's 51 degrees and then we subtract 5.8 degrees, that would give us our direction angle. This is going to come out to approximately 45 degrees if we two significant digits as we have here. So our direction here to here is approximately 45 degrees. Hopefully you can read this if you view this in full screen, and I hope you found this explanation helpful. Have a good day.